Welcome to day 5. Deepak devotes today's meditation on how to come out of the disconnect. Have you ever been described as a person who's difficult to know? Do people say you put up walls around you, or maybe you're in a relationship with someone who is like that? Over the years, I have spoken to so many people who told me that the main reason they disconnect when a relationship starts to feel too close is that they do not want to appear weak. They struggle to understand why they can never let someone in and allow themselves to love. Social scholar, professor, and best-selling author Brené Brown teaches us that we move away from things we need and crave the most. So if it is connection and intimacy you run from, it is love you crave most. Brené says one of the most important pathways to repairing difficult relationships is vulnerability. Embracing uncertainty, risk, and most of all, what Brené calls emotional exposure. For so many people, the walls go up because the deepest part of ourselves believes what the world says about us, whether it's the world in your head or the actual outside world. There's constant chatter trying to convince you that you are not enough, that you don't deserve the peace of true connection. But you don't have to believe it. Once you expose what you once perceived as a weakness, you will experience a floodgate of new emotions and create connections you never thought were possible. We're going to listen to Deepak guide us through this experience, and then we'll meditate together.
Heart-to-heart connections are so fulfilling that we need to look at why we avoid them or feel that they will be too scary to risk. As we've seen, the act of relating always involves either connecting or disconnecting. It comes as no surprise that some things are a turn-off or a turn-on, because the switching mechanism exists in every cell down to the level of our genes. When we disconnect, we switch off. Then our attention and caring no longer flow outward. We retreat into ourselves or shield ourselves with defense mechanisms. Coming out of the disconnect requires self-awareness. We stop assuming from the ego level that other people make us disconnect or even force us to disconnect by their negative behavior. In reality, at the level of the true self, you always have control of the on-off switch of relationship. We're not opening the way for self-judgment. There is no need for a "what did I do to screw this up" mentality when you examine where you disconnect. Self-blame is just another kind of disconnect, in fact. We need a better approach. To see what's really going on, we hold ourselves in silent, non-judgmental awareness and allow this awareness to heal the disconnection. It takes a shift in awareness to discover that love, peace, and lack of conflict exist inside us and have the power to change any situation. To make the shift possible, we must stop favoring the opposite viewpoint, which sees no power in awareness. From an ego perspective, it's one person, an insecure, isolated speck, standing against vast outside forces. In this view, which we've all experienced over and over, the outside world seems to have all the power, which is why the world's wisdom traditions came into existence, to counter what our five senses tell us and point the way inward. What wisdom says is simple. If you are connected with your source at the deepest level, the power to create a new reality for yourself belongs with you. Despite all the ego's neediness, there turns out to be only one need, the need to connect. When you have this realization and begin to act on it, disconnection heals itself in your relationships, because every disconnect, when seen in the light of awareness, is the same thing: a gap between the self you imagine yourself to be and the self you truly are. As we prepare to meditate together, let's take a moment to consider our centering thought. I only feel a need to connect. I only feel a need to connect. Now, let's prepare for our meditation. Make yourself comfortable and close your eyes. Begin to be aware of your breath and just breathe slowly and deeply. With each breath, allow yourself to become more deeply relaxed. Now, gently introduce the mantra, Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. This mantra means, my individuality is the totality of life, and reveals the truth that our real nature is always in relationship to everything in the universe. Repeat it silently to yourself. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. With each repetition, feel your body, mind, and spirit open and receive just a little more. Whenever you find yourself distracted by thoughts, noises, or physical sensations, simply return your attention to silently repeating the mantra. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. Please continue with your meditation. I'll mind the time, and when it's time to end, you'll hear me ring a soft bell. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi.